Shalom. I want to start off by saying Kal Halal Yomla, Yahweh, Ba'asham, Yahushai, Ba'asham, Reka Akadash. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone for teaching us the truth and who rule well. Peace and salutations unto the Akim that is spread around the four corners of the earth, spreading this word in sincerity and in truth. Shalom to the hopeful elect. I'm the brother Quetzal Zab Zion, coming back through the spirit and power of Yahweh, Ba'asham, Yahushai, with another lesson, with another video. And Lord willing, this video is edifying. So in this episode, I want to go into the book of 2 Thessalonians. So like 1 Thessalonians 5. Because in that time, Apostle Paul, he was preaching to the Thessalonians, you know, that we are living, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. You know, we're living in some beautiful times, you know, that the end is near. And if he preached that back then, how much more is it at hand right now? You know, as it says in Romans 13, verse 11. Let's get that real quick. Romans 13, verse 11. And that, knowing the time, that now is high time to awake out of sleep. For now is our salvation nearer than when we believed. Gone. So the Most High, he is shaking this place up. He is bringing this place through the fire, you know, the whirlwinds and the tempests and the wildfires, you know. The Most High is already kindling a fire here upon earth. And then he's going to send Yahweh Shai to, you know, totally decimate this place. And speaking about mainly Babylon the Great, which is America, with her philosophies, with her wine, you know. The Most High doesn't like that. The Most High is preparing to bring destruction upon America, just like how he brought destruction upon Egypt, you know, for all the wickedness that they were doing and also keeping the children of Israel in bondage. And the same thing is happening right now. And the Most High, he's going to make it such a glorious deliverance that people won't be saying, yeah, that's the power of the Israelite that brought them out of Egypt. No, this is the power that brought them, the children of Israel, out of the land of the north, which is America. You know, it's going to be so spectacular, so biblical, you know. It's going to be a biblical event, man. You understand? So you have to wake out of sleep right now because our salvation is nearer than when we believed. You see? Yahweh Bashem Yahushai didn't give us the spirit of slumber. You know, he gave us a spirit to be a watchman, to read and measure the time diligently in itself so that we know in what time we're living in. You know, so if you are still sitting on your couch, not making any videos, not preaching the word, stealing the word of your neighbor, you know, stealing the word of your neighbor is not preaching the word, preaching the knowledge that you have. That you have been given from Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, you know, you're going to have blood upon your hands. So now it's time to wake out of sleep. Do the work. Do what you got to do to enter safely into the kingdom, to be saved. Because just knowing the truth, you know, is not going to necessarily bring you into the kingdom. No, man, you got to do the work. You got to get your hands dirty, you know. The men that are getting their hands dirty right now, they are going to be the policing officers of the Israelites that are going to be put in the wilderness. You know, the ones that are going to be tested. Just like how in the time of Egypt, when they escaped Egypt, the people started to murmur. They still wanted to go to Egypt. You know, they got fed with manna, with angel bread, you know. But still, they were still worshiping the idols that they had in Egypt. So the Most High brought them in the wilderness, caused them all to die, and then he brought up their children into the land of Israel because all of them were still wicked. And in the same manner, the Most High is going to test a lot of Israelites in the wilderness. And we don't know for sure where the wilderness is, but there's a big chance that it's going to be in Brazil. You know, because that's a vast rainforest, which is very dense, you know, so the Most High, he can put the spirits in there, the Israelites in there, so that they can be tried. You know, so now is the time to wake out of sleep. Now is the time to do the work. Now is the time to seek the Most High 10 times more. You know, like how it was for us to go astray. Now is the time to seek Him 10 times more. And also, Isaiah 55, also one of my favorite scriptures. Isaiah 55 and 6, seek ye the Lord while He may be found. Call ye upon Him while He is near. Now He is near. How? You can see it on the by the prophets. The prophets, they are standing in the highways and byways. You know, He can't tell me that you haven't seen a Hebrew Israelite on a street corner prophesying about that we are the Israelites. You know, it might be a different group, IUIC, GOCC, or whatnot, but the Most High, you see, there's a different vibration now upon our people. You see, our minds are being elevated. We are being enlightened, you know. And when the time that the kingdom is going to be here, we are not going to have need of the sun or of the moon, because the Most High is going to be our light. He is going to enlighten us, you know. That's a figure of speech, you know. So He's going to be the... He's going to give us the full wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of how everything works and fits in each other, so that we can reset the whole earth, you know, because the whole earth is out of course right now, you know. So yeah, man, but to go to, not to drift off too much, let's go to the 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 1, and it reads, but of the times and the seasons, brethren, ye have no need that I write unto you. Come, because what I was going into, you know, we study the scriptures, so we see what time we're living in. We're measuring the time. Because let me just get it. Psalms 23. And this is Psalms 23 verse 4. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, which is America, you know, that valley of dry bones and the shadow of death. What do you see when death is around the corner? You see the shadow first, meaning it's going to creep up on you. You know, in the land of Babylon the Great, we don't have rest. There the Most High will give you a trembling heart, as it says in Deuteronomy 28. So, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Yahweh Shem Yahushua is with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. So that shows you the rod and the staff are two measuring instruments. You know? And wherewith do you measure the time? You measure it with the Bible. And what is the comfort? The comfort is also the Bible. You know, what was that? I believe 1 Corinthians or 2 Corinthians. It's also in the book of 1 Maccabees, I believe. God. This is, let me just get both. This is Romans 15, verse 4. For whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we, through patience and comfort of the scriptures, might have hope. You see? So the scriptures are the comforters, are the comforter. You see? The Bible is the comforter. And what did it say? Thy rod and staff, they comfort me. So that's the Bible is the comforter, and it's also the rod and the staff to measure the time that we're living in. You know? First Maccabees 12 and 9. Therefore we also, albeit we need none of these things, that we have the holy books of the scripture in our hands to comfort us. You see? So the scriptures, they're our comforter. The scriptures, they're our rod and our staff to measure the time. Gone. So going back, 1 Thessalonians 5 and 2. For yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night. Gone, as it says in Matthew 24. You know, like in the days of Noah. Let me just get it. instead of paraphrasing it. I believe it was 30. Was it 31? So I can bear with me for a second. I think I'm reading over it. You know how when you read it in the Bible app, it's different? Oh yeah, here. I know it was 30-something. But in your Bible, you can get it instantly. But on the Bible app, you gotta really read like, okay, where is it exactly? So this is Matthew 24, verse 20, 37. But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days that they were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage until the day that Noah entered into the ark. And knew not until the flood came and took them all away. So shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. Gone, because it got them by surprise. They didn't expect it, you know? And that's how the Most High is also explaining this, that when the Son of the Most High is going to come, he's going to come as a thief in the night, when you least suspect it, you see? Verse 3, 1 Thessalonians 5 and 3. For when they shall say, peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them, as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape. Gone, so... When these Edomites, Esau, Edom, which is a so-called white man, when they say peace and safety, that's when the destruction is going to come upon their heads. You know, then the Most High is going to rain these intercontinental ballistic missiles upon their head. You know, they are always talking about, yeah, we're in a good case, don't worry about it. World War III, we got it under control. We got all these deals and legislations and whatnot, you know, decrees with other nations. So, it's no problem. But yeah, that's exactly what the Most High wants. Just like in the days of Noah, when they least expected it, that's when he's going to reign. Back then, the first flood, the first death was the flood, you know, the rain by water. But this time it's also going to rain, but it's going to rain fire, you know, fire from these intercontinental ballistic missiles. 1 Thessalonians 5 and 4. But ye, brethren, are not in darkness, that day should overtake you as a thief. Ye are the children of light and the children of the day. We are not of the night nor of darkness. Gone. Yeah, man. So the Most High, he gave us that light. And who was that light? That light was Yahushua. Yahushua, he brought the truth back into the earth. And then he gave his disciples the instruction to feed his flock, you know, with the wisdom and knowledge that he came with and the truth. You see? So we have that light from Yahushua. That's why the scripture also says, for the spirit of prophecy, for Yahushua is the spirit of prophecy. So we are professing the things that still need to come to pass. We are forewarning you. Isaiah. Isaiah 60. Was it 60? Yeah. Isaiah 60 and 1. Arise, shine, for thy light is come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon thee. God, that's Yahushua is that light. He brought the truth. He enlightened us, you know. Because you have to walk with the spirit of Yahushua. You have to, because he's the mediator. You can't work straight through, you can't go straight to Yahweh. No, you have to do it through Yahushua. Verse 2, for behold, the darkness shall cover the people, and gross darkness. Salakia. Verse 2, for behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people. But the Lord shall arise upon thee, and his glory shall be seen upon thee. So these people, they are going to be in darkness, meaning they are going to be, how should I say it? They're not going to have a vision. They're not going to see, what's the best way to explain it? Because in Isaiah 59, it also speaks about that they grope in darkness, meaning they have no knowledge. Isaiah 59 and 10, we grope for the wall like the blind, and we grope as if we have no eyes. We stumble at noonday as in the night. We are desolate. We are in desolate places as dead men. Gone. Meaning you don't have a vision. You don't know what's going to happen. You don't have a clue. You don't have an idea what to do, you know. That's what it means to be in darkness, you know. But if you have the truth, as it says in the book of Psalms 119, then you have the light, you know which way to walk in, you know. The precepts of the Most High are as a light on my path, you see. So going back to 1 Thessalonians 5. Verse 6, therefore let us not sleep, as I was reading in Romans 13 and 11, where it's high time to wake out of sleep. Therefore let us not sleep, as do others, but let us watch and be sober. God, because the Most High, he sent us to be watchmen, watch and measure the times with the scriptures. And be sober, meaning being sober-minded, stay focused, don't get swayed away by the devil, by the wiles of the devil. Don't get taken away with their philosophies, because that's that wine, you know. The philosophies is, the whole alphabet community, LGB, you know, what I'm talking about. Don't get indulged in the deceits and the image of the beast. You know, that's that wine. Stay far from that and stay sober. For 7, for they that sleep in the night, and they that be drunken are drunken in the night. But let us who are of the day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and for a helmet the hope of salvation. God, you see, so the breastplate of faith, it starts with Yahweh Shai. You have to have faith in Yahweh Shai. That's the breastplate. And love. You have to love one another, you know. These two commandments are love the Most High with all your heart, and love thy neighbor, you know, as you love yourself. And for a helmet, the hope of salvation. Yeah, the salvation, that's what we're waiting for. We're waiting for Yahweh Shai. His name means Yah, He, Yahweh Shai, Savior, salvation. So that's, the faith is in Yahweh Shai, and the hope in salvation is also Yahweh Shai. Verse 9. For Yahweh, Bashem Yahweh Shai, had not appointed us to wrath, but to obtain salvation by our Lord Yahweh Shai. As we were speaking about, that the salvation is going to be greater than the salvation from Egypt. But to obtain salvation by our Lord Yahweh Shai, who died for us, that whether we wake or sleep, we should live together with him. So whether we die here on this side, or whether we make it through to the kingdom, you know, we are going to live and reign together with Yahweh Shai, because we are then joint heirs with Yahweh, Salakia, with Yahweh Shai. You see? Yeah, man, so those are a couple of scriptures that came to mind by just reading this through the Spirit, and I hope y'all got a message out of this lesson. And I want to say, Kal halal yamla, Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai, Bashem Rekha Kudash, Shalom Akim.